Philip and Nick.
So we've built an onboarding platform, and that's because we've been working in a company called StreetHawk for the last couple of years, where we've been doing automation for marketing people. So it's sort of come out of what we learned from customers. I've got an ask at the end of the presentation. There's a QR code and a bit.ly link. Just want to see if I can just get your feedback on about 9 questions, multiple choice, and I put it in the conversation session of the thing as well too. So bored with onboarding. So the big guys do a thing called progressive onboarding, which is that they actually educate you as you go in terms of how to use the app. If you've got a single purpose application, a lot of people try and build the onboarding in and make it in part of the flow. But over time, what happens is you build more features into your application and you actually have low uptake of what those features are. So the idea of tips, tours, and modals is something that's actually quite common on the web, in the web world. And there's been some startups in that space like WalkMe that have been funded like 90 million. And we said, let's try that for mobile. So here we've got Google teaching you how to actually do a multi-stop trip. We've got Slack here telling me how to use threaded conversations. They did when they released threaded conversations, they did a nice little 2-tip type thing during the day that you actually saw it for the first time. And over on the right-hand side, we have Facebook on St. Patrick's Day actually telling us that you can actually send customized things. So it's increasing engagement. So on customized things on St. Patrick's Day is with an Irish theme. So these are all kind of like usage of tips as a way of actually educating users to increase engagement. So we do the same sort of thing here. You've got like modals, various types of tips, and they can be strung together in a tour. So you can do that sort of stuff. And a lot of things that have happened over the last few years where you start up your application and the user gets hit with a carousel very first time that they always swipe through. They never look at it because the carousel is standing between the experience they want and the education you want to give them. So carousels have generally been proven to be fairly low uptake, and you can get that off our blog. Here's a sort of a chipmunk version of how our platform works. Over on the right-hand side, we've got an actual device connected to our platform. I'm sorry, it's iOS. I couldn't get my act together to do an Android one. But here's our dashboard. You've got an on-screen preview. You can choose tips or tours or modals and be able to actually customize that particular thing. So generally what we learned was developers are pretty bored about this stuff, but what happens is your product managers are always coming back and asking you to do more stuff. And it's kind of not very interesting. So we've made a kind of a platform that allows you to preview live, customize the way it is, and then shoot it out into the field without actually doing app releases. So with this platform, you do one app release in terms of just adding the SDK. And then from there on, you can actually just go ahead and give it back to your product manager or your marketing people to do that sort of stuff. So here, I'm not much of an artist, but I've actually customized a particularly horrible modal. And we do a whole bunch of stuff behind that, which I'll talk about in a second. So that's basically a dashboard, live previews, and then you can target the people you want to send it to. So what I'm after is actually feedback. So we interviewed about 50 people, devs, product managers, analytics, and growth hackers. And I was talking to the guy from SBS just before the start, and he said, I don't understand why it took us so long to actually get just a couple of carousels out. And it's because there's so many people involved. There's all these stakeholders, and it's highly visual, and it's upfront. And, so the developers have to actually do it, and it's boring. The product managers want it because they're actually trying to get growth and stuff like that. And the analytics people are trying to measure whether it actually really matters. So there's all these different people involved in that. And so that's what we are trying to actually solve, that to sort of take that mundane task and make it really easy for people to use and effectively push it back to the product manager. When you wake up in the morning, you probably imagine yourself doing, 50 impossible things before lunchtime, like MacGyver, the guy that actually just with a ballpoint pen and a paperclip can actually do lots of stuff. So that's the way you kind of start off your day, what you hope to be doing. You get to work and the product manager is saying, I've put in a couple of Jira tickets for you to actually make some font changes. And so this is the kind of situation you've got, that you've got some cool stuff you've got to do, and you've got a roadmap of a whole bunch of stuff in the next sprint that actually have to get done. But then there's all this other stuff that actually has to do with marketing, and it doesn't enhance your career, but it actually enhances the product manager's ability to actually, you know, create stickiness in the application. So we're trying to actually create a platform that makes that great for the product manager and great for you as developers to actually palm that particular stuff off. So as you can see, it's a couple of lines of code to get that in from an Android perspective, and it's very much the same in iOS as well too. And then you're up and running. It allows the product manager and the analytics people to actually really easily see what happens. We do a thing called A-B splits. Does everybody understand what A-Bs are? Just basically, I've got a champion, which is usually the default state of the app. So that's the champion. That's what's as good as I can do today. And then I have a challenger, which comes along, and I say, okay, I'm going to run this challenger with some onboarding, and I'm going to try a tour or try some stuff. And so here's where the challenger comes online, and the comparison to those two things. If you know Google Play, you've seen this with your Google Play Store wording type stuff. So very very similar in concept. We allow targeting, so you can target people when they're first time on a page. Have they been using the app for less than 14 days? Other stuff that you can push in from your back end. So we've got a REST JSON API. You know, when were they last seen? Are they new users, et cetera, et cetera? So it's kind of like a, you know, clickable set of filters that actually allow you to target that. So you can show a tip on any page at any time. So looking for you guys to answer the survey, if you don't mind. Appreciate it. I didn't actually put a question in there to just confirm if you are a dev or not, but maybe you can. There's a very last question where you can put a string in, so maybe you can just let me know if you're not a dev or you've got some ideas. We are hiring our next Android MacGyver, so in order to make something really easy for other people, we do a lot of stuff that's hard under the hood. So the Streethawk company has a whole lot of stuff to do with beacons and geofences and push, and this is just one of the products that sits on top of our platform. So very interested in talking to you if you're interested in that kind of work. It's an SDK company, effectively, and a SaaS platform. So this is the survey. As I said, 9 questions. So they're just trying to understand whether this is useful in terms of pushing the boring stuff back to the product managers. They can do things faster, they can iterate, and you don't need to actually sort of schedule that into your sprint. Okay, thank you very much. Was that under 5? So is there any questions or comments on that? Just I'll take human feedback as well. Really? I did that on an anonymous thing. What? Sorry, I'll do that straight away. What a drag. Okay, any other questions?
So when the app is installed on someone's phone, can you then go in and modify questions in real time so that they don't need to update the app itself?
Yeah, that's the whole point. So basically it's kind of like you can actually say that list of users, you know, this kind of stuff, you can target it. That chipmunk stuff that I did before, that's when you actually save that away, you can actually, you know, target that to actually fire out to people tomorrow morning or straight away, etc. So you can actually just basically be iterating all the time. The feedback we've been getting from the bigger apps is we've got to do this in multi-language sooner rather than later, so that you can actually just do different messages to different, you know, like, you know, money transfer companies, big travel apps, they're actually sort of talking about having to support 15 languages and so on. So, yeah. Yeah, so there is, I didn't show that we have a bunch of sort of standard templates to pick from there. It's at the moment we're not doing any really cool stuff with material design, but that's where we want to go. So we had to do a kind of like a 1.0 somehow. So little cool things like animation and so on, those sorts of things will be added. But definitely, I know Anurag, there's 2 guys here from our place if you want to talk to them, but basically they've been agitating to...
So has the SDK...
in our report.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I mean, what you saw today there was definitely an iOS look. Do you want to make a comment on just the Android side of it? Sorry?
It wasn't really very iOS. Like, iOS has rounded dialogues. It's got the two buttons.
Yeah, in fact, there's definitely templates for that. I could have shown you two buttons. You saw the buttons on the right-hand side. That was the customer's design, so the designers actually come back and said, Dave, your design is crap, you know, and this is the way we want you to make it look, so, yeah.
What is the customer's fault for design?
Well, I definitely am hopeless at design, so just ask my wife. So, yeah. Yeah. Definitely. So all the hard work that's happened for us is actually finding stuff that are in different types of layouts. You know, so, getting down to this guy down here, or this guy here is actually not rendered until runtime. So these are, so any of the buttons, top and bottom, so this kind of stuff here. So, yeah, so basically being able to actually access most of the stuff that's even rendered at runtime. The way we do it is we plug it in. When you connect the device, we actually have this, you put the phone into, the SDK goes into an authoring mode, and you click a button to actually send a screenshot, but it sends up the metadata of the design of that particular screen as well too. So,
I just find that,
No, it's not using XY, no. So if you'd flip this on, if you go into landscape, it automatically does that. So it maps to the fields and so on. And so that's a mix of names that we find at authoring time, but also algorithms to try and get back to that particular point. So, yeah. So, all right. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Dave.